and just completely ignoring them, as you can see, and just hitting the hammer.
Go! Get back to the truck! I'll take care of the cure!
Get to the chopper! Okay. All these huge things we're fighting would just go away. Whatever the hell they're called again. That's all I had to do was run past them. Oh, cool! Oh my god! It's huge compared to the Reaper! It's completely attached. Ooh. Get him. Oh, no, come back. Don't give up now. We need your help. Yeah, there you go. Cool. Oh my god, it's completely crushing it, those coils. It is huge. Huge compared to that freaking Reaper. How big exactly is that thing? That was pretty intense. We need ammo and our grenades back for Javik. What's hitting now? Debris?
Morton, is your cure ready?
Yes. Loaded for dispersal in 2 minutes. Procedure traumatic for Eve, but not lethal. Malin's research invaluable.
Awesome.
She's okay? Headed to safety now. Her survival fortunate. Will stabilize new government should Rex get any ideas. Good match. Promising future for Krogan.
Damn!
So if we don't get destroyed by debris...
Shroud tower. Must take elevator up.
You're going up there?
Yes. Manual access required. Have to counteract STG sabotage. Ensure cure dispersed properly.
Morton, this whole thing is coming apart. There's gotta be another way.
Remote bypass impossible. STG countermeasures in place. No time to adjust cure for temperature variants. No. No other option. Not coming back. Suggest you get clear. Explosion's likely to be problematic.
Not coming back?
Morton, no!
I got it,
Shepard,
just in time.
Please. Need to do this. My project, my work, my cure. My responsibility.
What?
Would have liked to run tests on the seashells.
Oh no! There's gotta be a way! I don't wanna say I miss you because I'm not convinced there's not a way. I'll miss you.
I'm sorry.
I'm not. Had to be me. Someone else might have gotten it wrong.
You're right about that. This part, whole part seems really quiet to me, guys. The audio, I'm not sure why. Hopefully you can hear it all right. Even the music sounds quiet.
Warning, temperature malfunction detected.
Is this the end of Morton? No! We'll save him somehow. Someone pick him up on a shuttle or something. A cruiser. My song.
Dispersal commencing.
My favorite song. Oh, he smiles. That's it? We're curing the genophage. Of a scientist Solarian. What? That. No. Morton? Oh, we're playing Vigil. This is the first time we've heard Vigil like this, I think. This is all curing? All curing. they... Morden, they better honor him, make a statue for him or something in their ancient ruins, which was... Well, modern ruins.
A long time ago, my father betrayed me in this place. His own son. He tried to kill me, so I had to kill him. Right over there.
Oh, I can't believe it. Morden!
Genophage reduced us to animals. But you changed that today, Shepard.
Morden.
Now we'll fight for our children. Not
changed it.
Them. It's just a pity Morden had to die.
He insisted, and he was a good friend. Oh my god, that's terrible. Oh, we have this theme. Can I just listen to this for a second? That's pretty cool. Okay, I guess it's over. So sad, though. He was a good friend.
He wouldn't have had it any other way. And I'm sure wherever he is, he's putting in a good word for us.
We'll name one of the kids after him. Maybe a girl.
But you, Commander, we can thank you in person.
I want a statue in his
honor.
Tell the
Turians I'll be deploying troops to Palavin immediately. And when you're ready to kick the Reapers off Earth, you let me know. The Krogan are back in business.
Goodbye, Commander.
What will you do now?
Spread the hope you've given us. Even now, there are clans gathering in the Kelphic Valley. I'll go speak to them and make sure this gift isn't squandered. Thank you for all that you've done. And know that Erdnot Bakara calls you a friend.
Bakara? Yeah, she's kind of dead inside right now.
Hell of a thing you just pulled off, Commander. Curing the Genophage? I never thought I'd see the day.
It wasn't me.
Rex has agreed to help the Turians, Admiral. We should get their full support.
It was Morden.
I take it that leaves the Salarians out of the equation.
The cost of their support was too high, sir.
Well, I'll defer to your judgment on that, Commander. Let's hope we don't need them.
You hope so.
Hack it out.
Crew update.
Commander, Erdnot Rex has begun sending troops to Palavin. You kept your end of the bargain, and now I'll keep mine. The Turian hierarchy will stand with humanity against the Reapers.
I appreciate that.
I'm glad we can help each other out. It's the only way we're going to defeat the Reapers.
That much is certain. To that end, several dry dock ships are ready to help build the Crucible. Garrus will coordinate them.
Yes, sir.
Cool.
And when the time comes to deploy it, the full measure of our fleet will be there for Earth. May the spirits watch over us all.
I'll start managing Turian support right away, Shepard. You must be exhausted.
And sad.
Morden dying. It can't be easy.
Mm-mm. I'll sleep when I'm dead.
We both know you need a clear head to win a war. There's no room for mistakes here. You should catch some shut-eye. I'll make sure Joker doesn't launch any suicide missions.
Anything happens, you let me know.
Can I just hug Garrus right now? He's a good friend, too. Oh, we go to sleep? Are we gonna see Intro Kid again? It's been a while. Where are you, Intro Kid? Oh, there's a lot of people here. Shades. I know I'm supposed to go that way. So let's see what happens if I get closer to these guys. And they go poof. Get Williams? I'm running. Intro Kid. Get back here, Androcan. No, 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 no. I can't run that fast. I'm in dream mode. Freddy Krueger has glued my feet to the floor with gunk. Who's this? Is that the kid? Intro kid! No, I won't let it happen. Don't run away from me. Reaper's gonna get you. Is he laughing or crying? I'm not even sure. What'd he do? Did he fall down? Oh. Oh, there he is. Morden, I heard you. Intro kid! Take my hand, intro kid! I know, you're already dead. I'm gonna see you die again. Thanks, brain!
It's open.
Yeah.
Shepard, there's something you need to hear.
Oh? Right.
Is this a bad time?
Just remembering the lost.
Thinking of some friends who weren't around thanks to this war. That's thanks to the Reapers, not you. Are you thinking about anyone in particular?
Caden. Oh, is that who was talking to me? Caden? Telling me to get to Ashley? Well, specifically, I miss Caden. But I also miss Morden and Intro Kid, even though we never were formally acquainted.
Caden back on Vermeer. He died buying us time to defeat Sovereign.
Seems like a lifetime ago.
Up against now, he might think his sacrifice was in vain. You know Caden would never think that. Yeah. That's one more reason I miss him. Didn't you have something for me? The Solarian Counselor has an urgent matter. Let me guess. She called the comm room. The Council must be taking the Crucible seriously. I'll see you downstairs.
Okay. I gotta use the bathroom. Wait, the door opened, but did I use it?
Commander.
Can I help you, Counselor?
Yeah, you're not happy with me.
I want you to understand that I owe my position to you, and it's not something that I take lightly. Were it not for you, that weak-minded Counselor Valern would still be alive, leading the Solarians down the sewage pipe. But now I'm forced to champion a cure for the Genophage. It's like saying we need a hurricane to put out a wildfire.
Capitalize on it? It's shared sacrifice. You know, we all live in this galaxy. It's not just you who would have to, you know, deal with the Krogan. In fact, I'd love if we had that opportunity to deal with mass Krogan waging war on us. That would be really preferable to what's going on right now.
Counselor, Krogan are about to die in droves, so your people don't have to. That's your message.
And that.
Human statesmanship at its finest. Speaking of, I need to talk to you about humanity's representative, Counselor Udina. He's moving vast sums of money.
Yeah, you're being nosy over
there. Talk about where it's going. From what I can tell, you won't like the news. Come see me next time you're on the Citadel. Ishiel out.
Commander, Admiral Hackett's available on VidCom.
That's the same Dalatras we spoke to before. We got Alliance funding. Alright, we'll check out stuff and then we'll talk to Hackett first.
Commander Shepard, something you need to talk about?
Reaper progress, yeah.
Do you know how the other races are doing against the Reapers?
Believe it or not, the Turians and Krogan actually seem to be getting along.
That was quick.
Erdnot Rex has deployed troops, and they're giving the Reapers a moment of pause.
Awesome.
The Solarians are still hanging on to Sirkesh, but the Reavers are starting to breathe down their necks, too.
What about the Asari?
They have to be feeling the heat. The Reavers are moving fast with the obvious intent of taking Thessia. Interestingly, the Reapers are leaving Parnak alone. It's the Yogg homeworld.
Really?
Can't say that I blame them. Yogg have teeth.
Yogg are that space fang.
If we lose this war, it might be them running the next cycle. It's easy to forget the Reapers don't destroy every species.
Right. Just the ones who can threaten them.
Right, well, the Yogg are not spacefaring, which probably makes all the difference to the Reapers. What about the Batarians?
What happened to the Batarians?
Never stood a chance, hit by the Reapers straight out of the gate. And without any allies to call on, I think the Batarians are history.
Oh my god, really? Not that I ever particularly cared for them, but... I don't want them to be, you know, extinct. Oh, but the Volus and the Elcor, I love them. Especially the Elcor.
Any word on the Volus and Elcor?
The Turians and the Krogan sent forces to the Volus homeworld, Irun. Mm-hmm. It might not be enough, but at least they've got Reaper forces bogged down in a nasty ground war. As for Elcor, they're still in the fight, though our projections show the Reapers encroaching on their territory soon.
And the Quarians and Geth.
Have we heard anything from the Quarians or Geth?
Something might be brewing near the Geth border, but our intel is sketchy. News is getting harder to come by as things get worse.
Well, we've liberated them from... it wasn't so much as indoctrination. We reprogrammed them to not want to help the Reapers, so... They should be fighting the Reapers. So, whatever's brewing, I hope it's a good one. I hope it's good. And what about the Allied forces?
What about the extra help we picked up along the way?
The Krogan and Turians have obviously been a big help. Erdnot Rex running the show is a bonus for us. Hmm. And that female Krogan you rescued is rallying more support from the other clans. I'm glad you disabled that mom and Tuchanka. We could have lost a lot of Krogan support as it is. We picked up some Turian troops.
Oh, good.
Good to hear.
That's a side mission. Good to know that that counts. I actually like that he even mentioned that. What about the Solarians?
How about the Solarians?
Interesting wrinkle. We've been getting back-channel commitments from the strike teams within STG. They're promising to back us.
Really?
Even after I cured the genophage?
Our intel suggests there are cracks developing between the military and the politicians. These STG guys know the score.
Excellent.
They're not going to jeopardize the entire Solarian Union just because some Delatras didn't get her way.
We totally called her bluff then. Excellent. I was hoping she was just, you know, spewing garbage. The Rachni.
What about the Rachni?
I wouldn't have believed it, but the Rachni are helping us build the Crucible.
Really?
You're kidding.
Huh.
Turns out they have a knack for weapons of mass destruction.
Huh.
In hindsight, I guess they'd know a thing or two about waging a galactic war.
Yeah.
No problems with them, then?
Little history.
Other than that. Scaring the hell out of our engineers, no. Not a lot of small talk going on there.
I'm wondering, they're helping build this thing. I'm wondering if they're working side by side or just doing their own thing and then showing, you know, progress and reports and stuff like that. It would be quite unnerving to work alongside a huge freaking, well, basically an insect. They are scary as hell. You know, nothing came of that. We saw proof, we saw, like, signs of the Rachni, you know, in this mission we just finished, and we didn't see any of them. Huh. Interesting. I wonder if maybe they would have showed up on, like, a harder difficulty. You know? Throw a bunch of Rachni into the mix. and Arya's reinforcements.
What about Arya's mercenaries?
Arya Tolok, there's someone I never thought we'd be in bed with. The Blood Pack will be useful. And violent. Mostly Vorchai here.
Mm.
We'll put the Blue Suns to good use. Intel says Darner Vosk is bringing his men, and that they're gunning for a fight.
Good.
The Eclipse are providing troops and mechs. When we find a Reaper soft spot, they'll help us hit it.
Cool.
Don't want to know how you got Arya's cooperation, but whatever you did, it was worth it.
I like his little line of getting in bed with Arya. And galactic readiness.
What's our state of readiness, Admiral?
I won't lie, Shepard. We're bogged down. Things aren't looking good in most sectors. We need to increase the tempo and chalk up some wins, otherwise this won't end well for the human race. Or any race.
Other than the Reaper race. Well, Shepard out.
Nothing more, sir.
Keep me posted. Hack it out.
The voice of Lance Henriksen. Pure awesomeness. Our buddy's not standing here. Right, we got stuff. Priority, the Citadel. A Salarian Council has concerns that Councillor Udina is a potential security risk. Go to the Citadel and discuss the matter in person. Alright. So we haven't found these other things yet, have we? Oh, we recovered the automated turrets. Well, that's a new thing. We still have to find schematics or power grid. This we found, we can return to Barlavan. New heating unit. Still haven't found that. And a rune. I haven't been able to get to a rune yet. New article about the Reapers harvesting. Even with all the Reapers' power, harvesting every sapient species in an entire galaxy can take decades or even centuries. The most time-consuming part of the process is gathering DNA from the population. To accelerate the effort, the Reapers follow a consistent procedure. Victims who cooperate, surrender, or are captured by husks are stored into camps. It is believed the husks possess receptors that allow them to analyze a victim's DNA through sight, smell, or touch. Victims that meet their standards are herded from the camps into processor ships. Those the husks deem insufficient are either turned... Those the husks deem insufficient are either turned into husks themselves or indoctrinated to serve as slave labor. Really? New power for the husks? Or new to us, anyway. The Reapers use this last option to give their victims false hope. Many captives who would otherwise fight back become docile when they see members of their own kind obey and survive. I'm so sad I can't go down to the med lab and see Morden. The processor ships reduce victims to a transportable liquid. Ooh, yeah, we've seen that, right? Into a black liquid. At the end of Mass Effect 2. Like in a slaughterhouse, the ship's design prevents victims from seeing or hearing what happens elsewhere so that they do not panic. You will be turned into a liquid, it's gonna panic here anyway. The victims are ushered into locking pods, then rent apart and dissolved into paste that is stored, flushed to storage vats. Oh my god. The rate of killing is phenomenal. Intelligence estimates suggest that there are more than 400 processor ships on Earth, killing approximately 1.86 million humans per day. Oh my god. In combination with battlefield deaths, disease, and famine, this pace will result in the complete depopulation of Earth within a decade. As the husks and indoctrinated slaves build more slaughtering facilities, the kill rate can only increase. You know, I thought this was more of a quick win. It's going to take them a decade to destroy us. I mean, still horrible, but... The Reapers seemed a lot more powerful in previous games, or at least it was alluded to, or perhaps the Reapers wanted us to believe so. Would always work. Oh, I've got powers here. I want to max out fitness first. Let me just look at this. combo detonations. Only combo detonations. You know what? Let's check this. So next we'll max one of these two out, obviously. Alright, let's check our galactic war assets type stuff. Krogan and Turian we have. Erdnot Rex. Look how high we are up, but still readiness rating at 50%. Erdnot Rex fought alongside Commander Shepard during the Reaper's first invasion attempt in 2183. Afterwards, he returned to Tuchanka and spent the following years rising to the leadership of his clan, championing progressive methods meant to strengthen the Krogan as a whole. Conservative elements were unhappy, but news of a successfully cured genophage has solidly united all of Tuchanka under Rex's command. Hailed not only as a great warrior, but a savior, the Krogan will follow Erdnot Rex into the maws of the Reapers themselves. Really cool seeing the rise of Rex like this. Really awesome. You deserved it all, buddy. You still do. Krogan clans, oh, we got stuff here. Krogan clans. Centuries of Krogan infighting abruptly halted with the news of a cure for the genophage. With their future restored, Tuchanka's clans have united in a show of force not seen since the Rachni War. The clans have also been stockpiling weapons of mass destruction for decades. Thankfully, their full destructive force can now be turned on the Reapers instead of Tuchanka. Their strength, size, and regenerative powers make the Krogan ideal shock troops. Yeah, really. Clan Erdnot. Clan Erdnot has become the unofficial but uncontested representative body of Krogan power to the rest of the galaxy. Within the past decade, Erdnot's warriors have either absorbed or wiped out clans Nakmor, Jurdan, Quash, and even the legendary ferocious Clan Rake. The discovery of a fertile Erdnot female rallied even more Krogan, regardless of affiliation to Erdnot's banner. I don't know. They're gonna have time with all this fighting to have sex? That's what I keep wondering. Krogan mercenaries. Many Krogan went fortune-seeking out in the lawless Terminus systems. Their imposing bulk and infamous brutality won them prized positions as bodyguards and mercenaries. When news of a genophage cure spread, these drifters were contacted by their clans and urged to join Shepard's forces against the Reapers. After centuries of aimless brawls and bleak futures, Krogan everywhere are heeding the call. Cool. Turian? Turian 43rd Marine Division. It was founded during the ancient unification wars that rocked Palavin over 2,000 years ago. The 43rd maintains relations with other council races, running joint training exercises with Asari, Salarian, and, more recently, Alliance military forces. Knowing how their allies fight has become an asset, as the 43rd's troops have the discipline and experience to integrate into any army on any battlefield. Turian's 7th Fleet. The Turian 7th Fleet was assigned the privilege and burden of guarding the Crucible during the weapon's construction and deployment. The fleet flies constant surveillance around the massive device, coordinating with Alliance security patrols and VI-run counterintelligence programs. The 7th Fleet knows what it would cost the galaxy if the Reapers breached their defenses. Every vessel's captain is prepared to make the ultimate sacrifice if it ensures the Crucible's safety. Updated, recovering the legendary banner of the 1st Regiment lifted the spirits of overworked Turian forces. Whatever works. Turian Engineering Corps. In a society where the military is synonymous with the government, the Turian Engineering Corps is responsible for everything from maintaining sidewalks to creating spaceports. Their fame spread beyond Palavin after they helped repair the damage done to the Citadel by Sovereign in record time. TEC engineers view the Crucible as the greatest challenge of their career and have sped up the building process with their expertise and equipment. Cool. Oh, 50%. Okie doke. Let's go do crew update.